Hi, and welcome back to our mindful and physical therapy-based workouts. This one is for upper body, arms, and core, and we'll have a ball. Put it between the knees and start on all fours. Take a moment to get into a position, the shoulders over your hands, the knees underneath the hips, and then go into a nice cat stretch from here. Stretching your spine out, and then go into a cow stretch. Trying to release the upper spine, thoracic spine. Pulling your navel in, rounding all the way. And extending. And exhale and pull your navel into your spine and connect to your abs. Connect to your pelvic floor. Feel the lift. And feel pulled from your chest, from your sternum. And then one more time. And tuck your toes under now. Inhale here. And then exhale. Lift the knees and press into the ball. Feel lifted from the ribcage, from your shoulders, face, and inhale down. And exhale. Pull the navel in. Pull the whole abdominal wall and engage between sit bones and pubic bone. Pulling in your openings. Connecting very deeply with your core. Feel how the inside thighs are activating and enhancing the pelvic floor activity. Using your breath, exhale and inhale. And exhale, press the hands into the floor. And take the energy from the floor, out of the floor, so be lifted at the same time. And then stay up here and do little twists, tiny, to feel into the obliques, feel the activity traveling. Keep lifting, keep refreshing, scanning through the body. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And then sit back. And we'll have one knee on the ball, making sure both side toes are tucked under. So now you're asymmetrical in your pelvis and you try to just lift that right knee, not pushing off with the foot, but you want to pull the knee off the mat as if it was glued to the mat, barely getting it off it. And exhale, lift and feel into the deep core. And inhale down, exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. So you should feel a lot of transverse here, but you also want to connect to the rib cage. Pull the ribs into the center line. Keep lifting through the sternum, keep lifting through the face and elongating through your neck. The elbows are micro-bent. Barely any weight on the feet. So the feet are just here to keep you in balance, but not to push off. And And then from here, go a little higher even, lifting that right side up and up and up, keeping your balance. 7, 6, 5, heavy in the right leg. 4, this should feel hard. 3, 2, and 1, and then release. Releasing your neck for a moment, and then come back. Other side, ball goes underneath the right knee. Again, the toes are here to give you some more stability, but not to push off. And then barely getting that left knee off the mat, really working hard, working deep down across the transverse, across your pelvis. Using your exhale, close the ribs, widen the shoulder blades, elbows micro bending. Navel is pulling in, pelvic floor is assisting. 3, 2, and then hold it up. And then from here, lift a little higher even for 10, 9, press the right knee into the ball. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and then stretch back. Now onto the forearms. Actually, just one forearm, and left hand goes behind the head. And we're gonna go into a rotation, meeting the right elbow, and then we're just opening here and closing. Now bring the elbow down. We'll have a lift here and then open. Lift and open. Squeeze the ball. Work your abs to lift. And connect to the obliques, rotators, 2 more, and 1. Get some mobility into that thoracic spine, and then switch. Right hand goes behind the head, and first we're just going to rotate in and open all the way. Getting some mobility into the other side rotation. And now lift, pushing both elbows down and open. spine stays neutral. Feel the axis that you're rotating around. Last two. And one. And then release. And coming up, relaxing the shoulders for a moment. And take the ball and hold it against your forehead. Now hover your pelvis right above your heels. Try to find your flat back. And then we're gonna tap the ball into the knees and back extension. And tap and press and extend. And press. You'll feel your abs here and your back extensors. So front side, push. Back side, extend. Inhale. Exhale. Work your glutes and extend into flat back, opening the shoulders, abs, back. Last four. Three. Two. And one. And then come up, take the ball in front of the chest. Pressing into the ball, engaging your pecs. Inhale, exhale, twist around the spine. Inhale, exhale, twist. And inhale. Working into the abs, the obliques, working mobility in the spine, finding that axis going right through you, connecting between the top of the head and your sit bones. Once more, each side. And then release. Ball goes between the knees, hands back into the mat. And you're gonna push up into a downward facing dog position. The elbows atypically are facing out because we're doing an overhead press here. So you go wide and the fingertips are facing inwards a little bit. Now the top of the head is pointing down, maybe even touching down, and then you're pushing away. You're trying to lift from the deep abs, the lower abs below the belly button. You connect the ribs still. You want to lift the sit bones up into the air. Work your arms. So really sink and push yourself out of the mat. Work your arms. Keeping the shoulders away from your ears, close the ribs. Pelvic floor is active, and then refresh the feet too. Toes wide, keep them alive. We'll have five more. Four, 3, 2, and 1. And then walk the hands towards your feet. Just hang here for a moment to release your neck. And then we're going to walk out into either full plank, or you can be on your knees if you want to have a little less of a lever, less weight on the hands. And then get ready for a full push-up. The elbow is still very wide, fingertips facing inwards. You're squeezing the ball, you're engaging your abs. The glutes are awake, the ribs are closed. And then lower and push. Inhale and exhale. And try to lift your face, your head away from the mat. Shoulder blades wide. Breathing through. Working the floor, working the mat. We'll have 10 more. Feel free to go down on the knees. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Knees down, sit back, release. Well done. And then down onto your stomach. Take the ball between the ankles. And then just lie down with the hands in front of the forehead. Inhale here. And then exhale. Lift and squeeze the ball. Lengthen through the hips. And extend through your spine. Expand through the shoulders. And then stay up in the air and just go up and up, up. Ten, nine, eight. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then just slowly push into a cobra stretch. Coming back and back into a child pose. Rolling up into seated, and we'll put the knees on the ball, both knees. Feel free to skip the ball and just do it on the mat. That works too. And now the hands are a little closer together, and fingertips forward, elbows back. Working out that distance of the knees. So you might want to bring the knees slightly back. And then try to do little tricep dips here, tricep push-ups, and see if you can start to roll back and forth with the ball or on the ball. Try to let those elbows face back. Engage your glutes, engage a lot of abs. Four more. Three. Two. And one. Now, take the ball between the knees. And now go full range. Elbows all the way down, press off, and up, and all the way down. So full range into the right angle, and push. The triceps should really be awake now, so you should be able to target it and to make it really hard. Also feel some lats and feel support from the serratus underneath your shoulder blades. So very active around here on the side. And we'll have three more. Keep lengthening through your neck. Refresh the abs. And then last one. And release. And rolling up. And hover your pelvis, take the arms into a right angle, shoulder level, and then squeeze in the front and open and squeeze and open. Working the arms, the shoulders, but also mobilizing, opening that chest a little bit from a lot of work on the hands, on the elbows in a plank situation. Work back extensors and glutes. Abs are supporting and stabilizing the spine. Two more. One more. And then one to just squeeze and up, down, up, down. Eight. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then take the hands behind the back. Take a stretch. Now get yourself onto the right elbow and we'll be on the ball. With the knees. So knees are stacked. So we're working the side now. Arm up. You might need some toes on the mat to just find some stability, but try to just kind of play around with that a little bit. So don't push too much from the feet. They're just there to support. And then you want to almost hang into that side, not into the shoulder though, and then pull from under here to bring the knees back, bring the ball back. So you pull and lift, lower and lengthen, shorten underneath and lengthen. Pulling the ball in, rolling it close and away. Be very mindful of the right shoulder, keeping the shoulders stacked and really working your side core. we'll have four more, making sure your abs are pulled in, pelvic floor is lifting. Three. Two. And last one. And then release. Now take the ball underneath the side. Extending through the top leg, extending through this arm. And then just lift and lower and lift. Now the top side is working. Maybe you need a little bit of support here. Depending on how well you can slide on that hand, I guess I'm getting lucky here with the floor being exactly in the right spot. And if you're a little more sticky on the mat, you might have to support a bit more with that hand. Working the top side now. You're also working the side of your neck, so you might feel that too. Last four. Three. Two. One, and then one to just stretch over. Deep breath. And then come up. Let's switch. And we'll start on the left elbow and the knees on the ball. Setting yourself up and reaching through the top arm. And now try to lengthen, releasing into the side, not into the shoulder, and then pulling from here to roll the ball closer. Making sure you're not starting to work the hip flexors, but you really want to stay in the side core. It shouldn't become a crunch or a merely just pulling in of the legs. Exhaling, engaging the front, closing the ribs, refreshing the left shoulder, lengthening through your neck. Last four. Three. Two. And one. And then release. Now take the ball underneath your waist, extending through the top leg, you need that. And then lift and lower, and lift and lower. Maybe using this hand to support a little bit. Maybe you don't need it. Now you're working the top side again. So top waist line. Taking your head with you, always looking straight ahead. Nine. Eight. Seven. Six, five, four, three, two, and one, and then one to just release. Stretch that side, and then slowly coming up. Getting into a seated position, ball between the knees. Inhale here, and on your exhale, slowly roll yourself down, maybe halfway, maybe three quarters, maybe you can go all the way with the arms overhead, and inhale, lengthening through your neck, and exhale, chin to chest, drawing in the abs. You have to tuck to be able to roll all the way, and inhale and exhale slowly down. Giving the ball a little squeeze. And then start to circle. And using your exhale, working into the depth of the abs, giving your gut a nice squeeze and compression, a nice massage. And then we'll hold it halfway. And just pulsing down and down, drawing the abdominal wall into your back. And we'll have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then come up and just release over the ball for a moment. Just resting my forehead here. And let the ball now sit in the lower back. And we'll have the thumbs, palms together, thumbs between your eyebrows. And then inhale here and go over the ball. And exhale. Working abs, working depth, working connection. Pelvic floor and ribs are just sliding towards each other. Drawing in. Using the breath. Try to be heavy in the legs and the feet. Alive, even the toes. Four more. Exhale and deepen, easing the shoulders in the neck. Three. Two. And then one, bring the soles of the feet together, really open through the knees, open through the hips. and release. Making sure to release right below the base of the skull, creating some space there. Breathing into your rib cage, into the lower back. And then come back. The ball still in that lower back. And we'll have the left hand on the chest, right hand goes forward, and now go over the ball and twist, and the right arm even goes over a little bit, and then to the right side. Twist, so leading with that left elbow, and to the right side. So think of an arc up and over in the diagonal. Exhale and inhale up and over and exhale, inhale up and over. Try to keep the pelvis in the center. And now stay up and over here and take the hand behind the head and then just do a small down and up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And release. Breather. And come back. Right hand to the chest, left arm out, and now twist and go up and over with that arm, and then exhale, diagonal. Working into the obliques, into the deep core. You need the transverse on at all times. So you want to pull the abdominal wall in, flatten. So the rectus abdominis can take over and push forward and out. Always working towards a flat activity of the abs without the bulging. Four more. And then last one. And stay here. And now we're just going to dip. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and release. Now the ball goes into the upper back, and we'll take a stretch, stretching out the abs, ribcage, the obliques, the thoracic spine, just enjoying. Feet are connected down into the ground, relaxing in the hip flexors, taking care of the neck, making sure you're elongated here, supporting with your hands. And then we're just gonna recover here, maybe bring the ball a little further down for some crunches here for a big emphasis on flattening in. And we'll lift one foot and the other foot, working deep, really making a big effort. Chin to chest, looking down, checking on that flattening process. Meaning you want to work the deep abs, you want to work the transverse, the pelvic floor. While working your rectus abdominis. You wouldn't get up without the rectus abdominis. So that one's on for sure. Last one each. We'll have another stretch. And then onto your elbows with the ball just kind of in the mid back with not that much weight on it. Now make sure you're still flattening, you're still pulling in. You're pushed out of the shoulders and then try to lift the legs. Squeeze the insides of the feet together and then tap to one side of the mat. The knees pretty much stay in the center. Work the shoulders, active in the arms. Very active in the core, not to arch. No arching. Neutral spine regarding flexion and extension, but you're shortening and lengthening the waistline. So side bend is going on. And you're working the lever of the legs. Five. Four, three, two, and one. And then release and just roll over the ball one more time, making sure to give your neck whatever it needs. Some might feel fine to just let the head rest on the mat and open the arms. Others really need some hands underneath the head. Maybe you even need a pillow if you want to establish a bit more of a relaxation pose. And then slowly rolling up and coming off the ball, lying down onto your back. Sure you're on the mat still, and then put the ball underneath the hips, underneath the pelvis, sacrum. Now just take a moment to roll right and left. And then extend one leg and pull the other knee in. So you want to just stretch out the whole hip, but hip flexor, but also into the abs and the obliques here, side abs. And then switch. Really nice stretch. Just take it in. Enjoy. And then put both feet back on the mat. Inhale here. And then exhale and just push up and draw your abs in, working just some backside, some glutes to extend through the hips. The pelvic floor is really nicely pulling in, helped by gravity. Abs so close to your spine, shoulders are relaxed. Ten, nine, press the feet down. Eight, seven, six, five, ribs down, hips up. Four, three, two, and one, and then just extend both legs for a moment. Make sure to keep the lower back happy. If this feels like too much, just bend the knees and put the feet down and roll right and left, if that's better. And then come back. Take the ball out. Put it between the knees. Inhale, arms up. If coming up like this is not an option for you, you just roll over your side. Exhale. Slowly rolling up. And then we'll have the hands behind you, and we're gonna push up here and then bend and extend. A little sinking in the pelvis, a little pushing up, a little sinking and pushing up. Working into the arms, into the shoulders. Abs are pulling in. Working some glutes and hamstrings too here, just by the way. 10. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And release. Extending the legs and then just lean over. And we'll have one last plank to finish this off. So just turn around onto the hands. Ball stays between the knees. And then push out into the full plank. Make it beautiful, long, well organized, neat, and then just push back and forward. Breathing through the body. Ten. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Release, sit back. And relax all the way. Just resting on the ball.
letting your chest drop, letting your head rest in the mat, the arms heavy, breathing into the lower back.
Slowly coming back and into a cross-legged and in the cross-legged, just relax forward,
releasing in the hips, the glutes, the lower back, releasing the belly.
And other leg forward.
Deep breaths. Be in your body here. Be right here in the moment.
And then come back. Take the arms up. Deep inhale, bring in all the good things. Palms together. And then trace your center. Well done. Thank you so much for joining. Please like and subscribe to stay in the loop for more mindful and physical therapy-based workouts. See you here again soon.